Did somebody say free plugin? Yes, it's called Smoothify, and it's available for Premiere Pro only. With the Smoothify plugin, what you can do is create graphs just like you would on After Effects, but with precision, and you can also save them as presets, which saves a lot of time. What's great about this plugin is that it's compatible with pretty much everything, so from scales, positions, to rotations, the very basics, which is kind of expected, but you can also use it with Twixter. So to put it short, anything that can be keyframed. First of all, you want to download it, head over to the website, follow the instructions. It's very straightforward if you know how to read. Then you want to launch Premiere Pro or restart it if it was already open. Head over to Window at the top, Extensions, and select Smoothify. I like to have it set up in between the effects panel, or all of these, should I say, and my video. So what I do is I just drag it in between. Like, so it's not even working. Hold on one sec. I don't know why it's not working. I'm going to undock the panel first and then try. So just in between them. Right there. I'm going to be showing you the very basics, nothing too advanced. So what we're going to do is use transform, keyframe the scale and the position. I'll show you how to apply a graph to it. So I'm going to create my own graph, apply it onto those keyframes, and then save it as a preset. So to begin, I've already added an adjustment layer. I'm going to head into effects and add on the transform effect, head back into effects controls, and I'm going to set a keyframe for the scale and the position. So let's go for 175 for the scale and move the position down to the hands. And if I head to the last frame, I'm then going to just reset them to their original values once I push this out the way, because there's like no space. So I'm going to click on the reset button for both of these. And usually you'd have to graph them manually. You probably already know about this. So you'd have to open the graphs for both the position and the scale, do it all manually, but with Smoothify, the entire process just got easier. So what you want to do is head in between the keyframes. If you're at the start or at the end, then it's not going to work. So just head in between them. What I'm going to do is add one of these built-in presets. So you've got this one, it starts off slow, speeds up, and then slows down at the end. So what you want to do first of all is make sure both of these have been highlighted, because I want this graph to be applied to both the position and the scale. If I wanted it to be applied to the scale only, I would uncheck the position and leave scale checked. But as I said, I need it on both properties. So enable both. And all I'm going to do is just click this play button. Well, it's more like a start button. So I'm going to click that and it's going to do its thing. That was really quick. I did not speed that up. That was in real time. So let's take a look at the result. Perfect. Okay, now I want to get rid of it. So how do I do that? You could either do it manually, so you could highlight them, delete, or you can just click on the bin icon right here and it's going to get rid of it. Now it didn't get rid of the scale because you can see it's not checked. So I'm going to select that, delete, all done. And best of all, our original keyframes are still there. Okay, let's try making our own custom graph. So what I'm going to do is make it speed up at the beginning. And also what I'm going to do is hold control on my keyboard so it locks it onto these points here. So I'm going to leave it up here and let go. This one I'm just going to tighten up a little. So this is my graph. I'm going to highlight the scale. So both of these have now been checked and I'm going to press go. That's going to apply the keyframes. And now we can take a look at the result. Perfect. Exactly how I wanted it. Right. So now I want to save this as a preset. So I'm going to head down to add and that's it. I can give it a name as well. So I'm going to name it fast. Now let's say I want to apply this graph onto another property. So let's go for a rotation. I'm going to head to the start, keyframe this and set this to 12. Then I'm going to head to my last frame and reset. All that's left for me to do is move my playhead to the middle. Make sure that the rotation has been selected. I'll deselect position. And select go. Make sure this preset has been selected. Yep. And select go. Now it's time to see if this really worked. Looks perfect to me.